In this episode, I'm gonna show you 5 cool tricks to optimizing your video settings for better performance during streaming or recording while using OBS Studio. Having performance problems? Stick with me and we'll probably work this out. The Elgato Cam Link takes your mirrorless, DSLR, GoPro, or camcorder and turns it into a higher quality face cam than any webcam could ever provide, without the hassle and headache of normal USB webcam drivers or their terrible settings configuration. Get an uncompressed, low latency 1080p 60 signal from your camera straight to your stream with this little device right here. Buy one via the link in the video description.
You may proceed.
I'm Evil's Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and welcome back to my OBS Studio tutorial course. I have many, many more videos on the software in the playlist, linked in the video description. Check that before asking many questions, and check the introduction video to learn how this course works. We're going to start with a couple basic tips that not everyone has considered. For example, if you're struggling with maintaining a steady frame rate while live streaming, consider lowering your target frame rate to 25 FPS instead of 30. It's just a few less frames, but can really help make sure your computer can maintain it. I wouldn't recommend this for recording, however. Viewers are much more likely to forgive certain video quality issues in a live stream than in a recorded video. Another great one is to stream at 854 by 480 or 480p instead of 720p or 1080p. This may be easier for your computer to handle and might actually look better to the viewer. The smaller a resolution you go without changing the bitrate, the better the video looks. A 2 megabits per second stream looks much better at 480p than 720p. Dropping below 480p might get a little too small for any sort of on-screen text to be visible, however. A big thing to check on for both recording and streaming is your resolution consistency. In the Video Settings tab and your Output Settings tab, you'd want to make sure that you don't have it set to downscale and then upscale your footage back up. An easy mistake is leaving the default downscaled resolution in the Video Settings tab and then setting the base resolution back as the scaled resolution in the Output Settings. This can trash your video quality and use up a lot more resources. Instead, only scale once, either in the Video Settings or the Output Settings, but not both. Next, you can change your CPU usage preset to faster, very fast, or super fast to reduce strain on your system and improve performance. This is in your streaming and recording settings for the X264 codec. This can really speed things up, but there will be minor impacts to video quality, so you will want to find a balance with the settings. Do lots of test streams and recordings before committing to a setup. Lastly, if your system supports it, you can use hardware accelerated encoding to speed things up. This includes Intel QuickSync Video, AMD VCE encoding, and NVIDIA NVENC. Whether or not your system supports any of these will vary based on your computer. QuickSync is only an option available on certain Intel processors. AMD VCE and NVIDIA NVENC is only available on newer desktop graphics cards or very high-end laptops with dedicated graphics cards of the respective company, AMD or NVIDIA. To set this up, head back to your output settings and click the drop-down next to encoder. If you have something other than X264, you can give it a try. It might perform way better than the normal X264 software encoding. And that's it! My top 5 tips for optimizing your video settings in OBS Studio and squeezing better performance out of this awesome streaming software. Have any extra tips? Leave them in the comments below and help each other out. I hope this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it was, punch that like button, kick it, smash it, whatever you want to do, and subscribe for awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come hit the follow button over on Twitch, drop me a message in chat. Until next time, I'm Evil's Vox, happy streaming.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/eposvox to sign up.